This person goes on to say, I've forgotten how important the rest of our legs are. This is what I needed to remind myself to train more than just my aerobic capacity. What we got going on here? Outrun your echo. Cloud is in the rotation again. Come on, carbon plate.
Hello, my love.
Oh,
cheers. Good morning.
Good job with your
How
morning
you
run. I love
it. Morning run. We're doubling today so we can go a little easier on Sunday.
Oh, that's nice.
But there's a what's it called? A hitchhiker. There's a hitchhiker in my shoe. All right. Let me show.
Let's go away.
So that's the only thing about on shoes. All right. Let me sit down. Hold on. All right. You ready? You ready for this, my love?
Yeah.
So, you know when you get a hitchhiker, is it like when you get a sticker or something,
oh, yeah.
like a pokey thing in your shoe, and it just is poking your foot?
Ah.
Well, look at the bottom of this On Cloud Boom Echo. On Cloud Boom Echo is the name of this shoe. Ugh, look at the size of that hitchhiker. Can you see that? All right, I'll get a nice close-up for all of you. Listen. It's an interesting thought process going, you know, engineering a running shoe like this. But yes, that's a pretty good hitch. Like, look at the size of that stone stuck inside that shoe.
Yeah.
Kind of crazy.
I mean, that is insane.
Right? So.
Plus that extra weight now.
I know.
In your life.
Yeah. I will weigh this shoe in a minute. We're going to enjoy some coffee. I'll weigh it with the stone and without the stone just to see how much weight. By the way, here's the run on your screen now. Nice and easy. I think it was about 8:30, 8:40 a mile is what it felt like. And just bopping along.
I was going to say, back to bopping along for you.
It was another, it's crazy. It was another, I think it was 19,000 feet of vertical gain
this week.
What? So there it is again on your screen. It just is a lot. But
wow.
We're finally starting to come down. The base is built. The aerobic engine is definitely built. Now it's time to start picking up speed this week.
Well,
isn't that exciting?
It's exciting.
Hon, we're moving.
Yes.
And we're running Pikes Peak.
Oh, yeah. Real quick.
Boom. Just gonna knock those two things out. Next 5 weeks. Hello. Hello, Dolly.
I like that.
So.
Just get it done.
Just get her done. Move, buy a new house, run Pikes Peak. Oh.
Oh my gosh, I can't wait.
It's coming up.
It's nice. Okay, they are close, but it's nice that they're not.
On the same weekend.
Right.
Yeah.
Or even within eight days of each other, I think would be hard.
I mean, again, seek out an experienced realtor.
Yes.
We love our, I mean, he's been doing it. He has shown 35,000 houses in the Denver area.
Yeah, in his career.
In his career, 35. So he just understands the Denver. I'm telling you, the fact that we get to move so quickly and don't have to be moving, you know, 5 days before Pikes Peak.
Right.
It's crazy.
Right. The art of the taper excludes a move.
Don't move during your taper.
Yeah.
Especially.
Well, 101.
Especially, yeah, tip of the day. Don't move during.
Your taper.
Your taper. That's a good one.
When I first saw this, I thought it was dog poop.
Ah.
I mean, gross, right? What would happen? You'd have to throw the shoes away.
Yeah. That would be bad.
That's so funny. Yuck.
So, that's funny.
That's interesting.
Cheers.
That's amazing.
Gotta go.
Okay, well, see you later.
Gotta go weigh the shoe. Boom. With a rock.
Still weigh. All
right.
Okay.
Time to get organized in the studio. Actually, you know what? I'm finally have a hot minute to start packing. Not everything, because we've still got 2 weeks here at this house, but really start to think about, okay, what needs to come to the new house? What needs to stay? Well, what needs to be moved on? So it's time. But first, let's weigh this. I don't know what the On Cloud Boom Echo weighs. The stone is still in there. We'll take that out for the weighing. All right, here we go. With the stone in my size, 7.8 or 220 grams. And without the stone, 7.2. All right, there you go. That's kind of funny. You know what that's on par with is it out here is the Audios Pro 2. I believe is right around that same weight. Very interesting. Okay, actually, on my mind. Speaking of, there it is. Okay. Oh, can't resist. All right, let me take this guy off. Oh, so close. I was right. So 200 grams for the Audios Pro 2. Hold on. 7.1 ounces is what I saw. So, oh, very fascinating. That's, you know, I'll just say, okay, I'm not going to stop. You ready for this? Hold on. Is about an ounce heavier than the ASICS MetaSpeed Sky. Great job, ASICS, crushing it in 2021. Oh my goodness. See what I mean? 6.1 in my size. That's why I'm saying this guy is frankly a nice solid contender for the Next Percent 2. Stop the madness. Okay, now I'm just geeking out. All right, here we go. There it is. Come on now. Next Percent 2 in my size. Oh, I was a little off. So it's 6.2. So the 6.2, 6.3. So the ASICS MetaSpeed Sky is ever so slightly lighter. There you go. Contenders, Marathon Racing Shoe Matrix Vlog, upper right-hand corner from 2020. All right, let's go get a box. Hello, my love. Hello, my love.
Remember I'm just our patio.
Remember our future organization?
Yes. An upgrade from carport.
Right.
From spiders and dust.
It's all about to change. Do you have tape?
Oh.
Packing tape. Oh, yes, she does. I need to build a box. Oh, not only do you have tape, you have a tape gun.
Come on, you bought me that.
Heyo.
You know it's true love when he buys you a tape gun.
Everything good?
Marvelous. Oh, she's had the great idea of doing an industrial, like a commercial wash machine and dryer that like a laundromat would have that could fit
Yeah. Like four loads.
Why not?
Isn't that so smart?
Smart. Four boys.
Four boys, doubles.
Why not?
Come on.
Hon, I love it. Oh boy. Oh boy. Drop in silverware. Okay, dinner is done. It's about, I'm kicking swords on the ground. It's about 8 hours later from that last clip. Always so much to talk about. Here we go. First, we'll get you the comment of the day. Shout out to my brother. He doesn't know I'm going to do this, but a shout out to my brother here in a second. And the On Cloud Boom Echo. Oh man, 9mm drop. I believe we're looking at $270. Upper, very lightweight, very breathable. Pretty excited about the upper. On, gonna comment on the shoelaces. A little thin. The tongue might need a little more padding on the tongue for those shoelaces. I might swap out the shoelaces, actually. I felt them ever so slightly on the top of my foot. And it does have that speed board, okay, for their version of nylon, you know, carbon fiber nylon plate. It's not... Okay, the one word that jumps out at me, and here's Henry, he found me. The one word that jumps out at me for this shoe thus far, and of course, this is not my first impression, I'm not guaranteeing we're going to 50 miles, is smooth. That's the word that's jumping out at me. Not a crazy amount of energy return, but it did feel very smooth through the foot strike, through the gait cycle, which is nice, okay? 7.2, was it, ounces? So not the lightest marathon racing shoe out there on the marketplace, but those are my first thoughts, okay? I'll stop there, and I'll keep you posted if we do take it to 50 miles. Comment of the day, here we go. You ready for this, Henry? Game Tame says, this is honestly the most inspiring video I've seen for running in a long time. Thank you. This is about yesterday talking about suppleness for the Achilles tendon in the lower leg. This person goes on to say, I've forgotten how important the rest of our legs are. This is what I needed to remind myself to train more than just my aerobic capacity. I need to get stronger. Game Tame, you get the comment of the day. Thanks for taking the time to drop a comment down below connected to the question of the day. And shout out to my brother, Joseph, throwing down. So there was a vlog fan in Alta in Utah this past weekend. There was a Cirque Series race. Shout out to the Cirque Series. Amazing short mountain races. If you're interested in getting into mountain racing, check it out, CirqueSeries.com. I'm guessing down below in the description. And just like 6 to 8 mile races, not long, just an intro, but they are kind of, you know, a lot of vertical, but they're not long. It's like different than the ultra running world, which is actually kind of nice. A little, you can go race, put yourself out there, you know, work hard, but you don't have to beat your body up too much. It's kind of nice. So my brother took second behind Joe, of course. Oh, Joe and Joseph. And then I don't know who third was, but shout out to my brother in the vlog fan who grabbed this clip at the awards ceremony. All right, so good times. Question of the day. Speaking of racing, how was your race this weekend? Or how was your long run? All right, race or long run? Tell us a good story. What was the distance of the long run? What was the distance of the race? Do you feel like you met your goal? Boom, sound good? DGR strong, onward and upward. Right, Henry? Can you pound it? Not yet. We're working on it. Mwah. Oh, we love you guys. Okay, we will toss it to the, you know what? We'll toss it to a Cirque race probably 2 years ago because they were all canceled, I think, last year. So from 2 years ago at Arapahoe Basin. Cirque race right there, right there, right there. All right, seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.